Hello everyone, this is Ashish Jain. In this lecture video, we are going to study a new chapter of business statistics, that is analysis of time series. First of all, we need to look out why we are going to study this chapter, means what is the purpose of studying this chapter. Time series. See, in the daily life, we actually analyze on the various patterns. So that we need to know, like, so that we need to take the efficient decisions in our life. Government also analyzes this type of time series so that they can also achieve some of the targets, so that they can also take all the decisions in the favor of the public, right? So time series, that means basically the thing is that suppose a shopkeeper want to analyze what would be the likely sales in the upcoming festivals. So he or she need to analyze the past data, like what kind of attractive discount we need to provide to achieve the maximum sales. So that they would definitely analyze, that is with the help of the time series, right? So what is actually the time series? That is a set of data that are already arranged in chronological order. To analyze that particular data, that is called time series. Right, so that means we need to actually study this chapter so that we can take all the decisions efficiently in our daily life, right? So now we need to see what are the various types of time series, or we can say what are the components of the time series. So we have the four types of time series. First one is, that is secular trend. First one we have secular trend. See, the secular trend basically we commonly basically use for, like, the rising trend of the population, prices, employment, sales, income, production. And we not only analyze this trend not only for the short term but also for the long term, right? So secular trend basically just means we are actually going to predict the, like, what would be the likely employment rate or unemployment rate or the sales rate or what would be the income in the upcoming future, right? So that is called time series. Like, suppose if I take an example of a self income person, right? And suppose that person is basically a non government employee. Now his salary is basically totally depend on the annual increment as well as the dearness allowance, right? So as per the dearness allowance, he would likely to know, like, what would be the level of income in the next 2 years. So suppose if we analyze that the current the dearness allowance is suppose 5%, right? And the inflation rate is suppose 10%, right? And suppose, like, we take examples that DA is equivalent to this is the inflation rate, and the DA also equivalent to inflation rate. So what would be the level of income in the upcoming future? So that person will analyze with the help of this chart. Like, suppose today is 100, now the next year that would be 110, then next year would be 121.1, right? So with the help of this chart, he or she will analyze what would be the likely level of income in the next upcoming years. So that is called the secular trend, right? That means there is a trend that is a more or less fixed, right? So that is called secular trend, and that we analyze in a long term or as well as in the short run, right? So that is all about the secular trend. Now moving to next trend, that is called seasonal trend, or you can say seasonal variation. Seasonal variation or trend, right? Like as you can suggest with this name, like the farmers are totally depend on the weather as well as the climate conditions. So they will also look out for the weather condition report for the next 5 or 6 months, because they also need all the information, like what kind of like farming they need to produce, like or for the growing of the crops, so that their loss would be minimized, right? So they are totally depend on the weather and climate conditions. As well as, suppose if I like just earlier that I have used the example, suppose there is a person who is a salesman, right? And he want to analyze like in the festive season, the sales are at highest point during the throughout the year. So he need to analyze like what would be the likely sales this year. So he will analyze with the help of the time series. So that is called seasonal, right? Like in every season, right? You can say in every 6 months or maybe in quarterly, right? So it may be totally depend on the season, right? The next one we have, that is cyclical variation. Cyclical variations. See, every business basically face the problem, or you can say face the every phase of the business. Like it may be upward movement, it may be downward movement. So all kind of these phases are must be faced by the business. See, as I told, like every business need to face all the kind of phases during the life cycle of the business. So what kind of cycle they need to face? This line that is called normal line. That means you can say like they have analyzed that they will achieve this kind of sales. So more or less they are achieving the average sale, that is called normal, right? That means the sales are not at highest position nor at lowest position, that means on average. So that is called normal phase. Now the first one, that is the prosperity. That means suppose if I launch a product, so at initial point my position will be like prosperity, right? And if I suppose do not innovate in my product, or if I do not like provide any kind of product that is not valuation for the customers, so that means now I will come to the decline phase, right? And then I will definitely reach up to depression point, that means at the lowest cycle of the business, right? Then at this point I need to take various decision to improve my business, okay? So that is called the improvement phase, right? So these are the phases of the business cycle. So that is called the cyclical variable. That means in every phases, or you can say in every cycle, we need to analyze like what would be the likely sales, or you can say likely production, right? Or you can say the demand, right? So they need to analyze all the things also, right? So we have done the third, and the last one is we have, that is called irregular variation. The last one we have, that is called irregular variation. Irregular variation means that is something that is random, or you can say the accidental. Like so, like we have all seen the pandemic, and we have also analyzed the stock market. Like stock market suddenly like crash during this pandemic. So that is called irregular variation. That means sometimes that we cannot predict, because the upward or downward movement of the stock market are basically irregular, right? So that is called irregular. That means that is something that is called erratic. That means we can't analyze, or something that some that trend that we can't that is not repeat. Yeah, right. That is not repeat. So that is called irregular variable, right? Now moving ahead towards the measurement of trend. मेजरमेंट ऑफ एन ट्रेंड इन द सेंस लाइक हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू मेजर दीज ट्रेंड्स. सी वी हैव स्टडीड दीज फोर टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रेंड्स, दैट इज कॉल्ड सेक्युलर ट्रेंड, सीजनल ट्रेंड, साइक्लिक ट्रेंड एज वेल एज द इरेगुलर ट्रेंड. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी लाइक हाउ डू वी नीड टू मेजर दीज टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रेंड, राइट. सो वी हैव अगेन द फोर टाइप्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट ऑफ ट्रेंड. द फर्स्ट वन वी हैव दैट इज graphic method. The second one we have semi average method. The fourth one we have moving average method. And the last one is least square method. These are the four types of measurement of the trends, right? Now let's start with the first. The first one that is called graphic method, and this we all do in the practical part of the business statistics. That means when we do the Excel part, right? And the second one is that is called semi-average. This is not the important part, so we always that is ignore this part. So you don't need to actually study this type of method because this is very 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 basic. So like the very illogical, right? So we basically study the two types of trend, that is called moving average and the least square method. Now let's start with the moving average. That means moving average in the sense that means we are going to basically we analyze the trend like on the basis of 3 years or 5 years or 6 years, right? So that is called moving average. First of all, we need to we would definitely have a question in mind like why do we follow moving average. Suppose we are going to analyze the past data since independence, right? Since independence, like suppose in the case of population, so like since independence, like since 1947, we are going to analyze like what is the actual rate of percentage of population rising over a period of time, right? So that is a huge data. That is a huge huge data. That is of around 74 years, right? So when we have a large volume data, we need to actually divide the time in equal parts, like in the 5 years or 10 years, right? So that is called moving average. Like we are going to analyze the rate of population in 5 equal years, right? Like first 5 years, then second, then third 5 years, right? So that is called moving average. That means we apply moving average when we have a huge data, right? So let's start with our first question. Calculate the 3 yearly moving averages of the production figures given below and determine the trend values and find the short-term fluctuations. Short-term fluctuation in the sense that we have actually the two types of short-term fluctuations, that is called multiplicative model and the additive model. Multiplicative and additive model basically they basically helps to analyze the trend, like which type of trend we have. Like we have studied the four types of trend, the seasonal, the secular, the irregular, right? So what kind of a trend that we have, we are going to analyze. So that we analyze with the help of the short-term fluctuation, that is called multiplicative model and the additive model, right? So in this question that we are going to analyze the time series with the help of the 3 yearly moving average. That means we need to divide our data in the three years, right? So we have the data from the year 2006 till 2020. See, we all need to make this format. First column is for the year, the second column is for the production. Since we are doing this, that is called the moving average, and which moving average, that is the we are going to analyze it on the basis of 3 years, right? So let's see how do we do moving average. See, the first step is that is we need to take the sum of first three production So the sum of the first three production is, first one is dash, next one would be 66, total of first three production, right? And then we will take, now we need to skip the first production, first that is 2006 production. Now we are going, we need to take the sum of next three production, like 21, 30 and 36. So that would be 87. Right, and next sum would be that we need to take, that is the next three, that is 30, 36 and 42. So that would be 108, right? So we need to keep sum the 3 year production like this. So I'm just writing it directly, 124, 138, 152, 169, 189, 207, 226, 246, 267, and 287, and last one is nil. Now the next step is, that means that is a moving trend. No, this is not moving trend, this case would be moving averages. That means now we need to take the average of all these. That is, first is, that is 66, and 66 is the sum of 3 years production, so it must be divided by 3. So that is equal to 22, then 29, 36, and then we have 124. That would be 41.33. Next is 46, then 50.67, 58.33, 63, 69, 75.33, 82, 89, and then 95.67, right? So we have labeled the moving averages. Now the short-term fluctuations are multiplicative model and the additive model. So how do we calculate this type of model? So first, let's look out for the additive model, sorry, multiplicative model. So for this, we need to divide the 21 by 22. So that is 21 by 22 multiplied by 100. So that is equal to 95.45. Then 30 divided by 29, that is equal to 103.45. The next would be 100. Then 101.62, again 100, 98.68, 96.01, 100, 101.45, 98.23, 100, 101.2, 99.3, right? So this is the multiplicative model, and in the case of additive model, you just need to minus this one. That means 21 minus 22, that is minus 1. First one is would be dash. Then 30 minus 29, that is 1, 0, 0.67, 0, minus 0.67, then minus 2.33, then 0, 1, minus 1.33, 0, 1, minus 0.67, right? So this is the way of calculating short-term fluctuation, that is called additive model and the multiplicative model. See, as I told you, Like we calculate the multiplication model and the additive model, that is, that are called short-term fluctuations, and we calculate these short-term fluctuations to analyze the which type of trend we have. So if we apply the additive model, so if we analyze that what kind of trend here that we are going that we are observing. So see, start with the negative. Then it's rising over a period of time, positive, 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 and then negative, then positive, then negative, and then it's positive and then negative. So you can say it moving upward downward position in a like a very seamless manner. So you can say that this is a cyclical trend, right? This is a cyclical trend. Okay, let me talk about the multiplicative model and the additive model in detail. See, the multiplicative model basically means that the sales are totally dependent on the all types of the trends. Like we have the secular trend, right? Then we have cyclical trend. Then we have seasonal trend, and then we have the irregular trend. The first one is secular trend, then cyclical, then seasonal, and then irregular. That means the overall sales depend on these. That means they are you can say the compounding factor is involved, right? And the next one is that is called additive model. In this case, suppose if we are going to analyze the sales, so that means the sum of all the types of trends that comes which becomes additive model, right? That means this type of trend is not dependent on it, or this type of depend on not on this, but in this there is a compounding. That means each type of trend are totally dependent on each other, right? So that means in multiplicative model we actually analyze the trend with the help of the in the form of the ratio, or means in the form of percentage. But in the additive model we actually analyze the which type of trend that we are observing, that we help in the form of the absolute form. So if we look at the figure, the multiplicative model basically tells in the ratio form, or you can say the percentage form, but in additive model they actually give the absolute figure, right? So this is the first question, that is totally dependent and that is based on the moving average, right? And which type of moving type average we have done, that is called 3-yearly average trend, right? Now moving to next question number 2. Calculate 5-yearly and 7-yearly moving averages for the following data of the number of commercial and industrial failures in the country during this. See, we have the same questions, same question. The first I have done, that is on the basis of the 3-yearly moving averages, right? So this is more or less same. Thus you need to look out the which type of moving averages that that is, you need to take the first, you need to take the base, that is 5 year, and then take second part, that is 7 year, right? So question number second is for homework. Now moving to next question number 3. Estimate the trend values using the data given below by taking 4-yearly moving averages and eliminate the trend. Eliminate the trend in the sense, this is equal, that is, they are asking the same, that is, they are asking for the short-term fluctuations, right? See, when we do the moving averages, suppose in the odd figures like 3 years average, 5 years or 7 years, so more or less they are same. But when we do the moving averages in the odd, that is in the odd way, like 4 years moving average, 6 years, 8 years, 10 years, so we need to take up the some more additional step. So question number 3 I'll do, okay. दिस इज द बेसिक फॉर्मेट फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड. द फर्स्ट कॉलम इज फॉर द ईयर, सेकेंड कॉलम इज फॉर वैल्यूज एज पर द गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. द नेक्स्ट कॉलम इज फॉर दैट इज द फोर ईयरली टोटल. सो द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज सेम, दैट इज वी फर्स्ट वी नीड टू टेक द सम एज पर द नंबर ऑफ ईयर्स. सो दैट मीन्स इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द सम द फर्स्ट फोर ईयर्स, दैट इज दिस, एंड द टोटल इज दैट इज 104.8. बट जस्ट यू नीड टू टेक आउट द स्टेप्स केयरफुली, दैट मीन्स वेयर यू नीड टू पुट अप द वैल्यू. सी वी आर टेकिंग अप द सम ऑफ द फर्स्ट फोर ईयर्स, सो दैट मीन्स वी नीड टू राइट द वैल्यू इन द मिडल ऑफ दिस ईयर, दैट इज 104.8, राइट. एंड द नेक्स्ट वी नीड टू टेक द टोटल ऑफ द नेक्स्ट फोर ईयर्स, राइट, द नेक्स्ट फोर ईयर्स, एंड द टोटल इज दैट इज 108.8, एंड द मिडल पार्ट इज दैट इज दिस, सो 108.8. द नेक्स्ट वुड बी 112.8, देन 115.8, देन 132.6, सॉरी दैट वुड बी 115.6. द नेक्स्ट 143.8, देन 156, देन 168.1, देन 176.5, देन 184.4, राइट. And then next column is for that is four yearly moving average. That means we will take the average of all this sum. So that is 104.8 divided by 4. That is equal to 26.2. Then 27.2. Then 28.2. 28.9. 33.15, 35.95, 39, 42.02, 42.3, 46.1. And the next column we have, that is 4 yearly centered. 4 yearly centered in the sense, now we need to take the average of these. Average of these, why? Because if we take the average of this, we will get figure here with actually define the average of this year, that is 2008. Because we need to take up the average, that means which that this average is belongs to this year, right? Because because we can't take this value, that is suppose we need to find out the which this average is belong to which year. We can't find out because this value is actually lying in the between of 2007 and 2008, right? So for this we need to calculate the we need to add up the another column, that is 4 yearly centered, and in this case we need to take up the take the average of average of the 4 years. So how do we do? First we need to take the average of first two values, and that would be 26.7, and this belongs to 2008. Then 27.7 belongs to 2009. Then 28.5, 31.03, 34.55, 37.48, 40.51, 42.16, 43.21, and 45.11. See, in the all the cases of the moving average. In the case of even moving averages, we need to add up the one additional column, that is 4 yearly centered or 6 yearly centered or 8 yearly centered, right? And the rest the steps are same. Now we need to analyze the trend, so that we will do with the help of elimination trend. That is, first we have elimination, that is multiplicative model, and the second one we have additive model. So in the additive model, what we do, that we do that is this 27.3 divided by 26.7, right? So that would be 100.25. The next one is 102.17. The next 98.42, 93.78, 87.12, 120.86, 97.01, 97.96, 97.66, 102.86. Same in the addition, that means we will subtract the 27.3 from 26.7. So that is 0.6, 0.6 minus 0.5 minus 1.93 minus 4.45, 7.82 minus 1.21 minus 0.86 minus 1.01 positive 1.29. Okay, so I think you have understood this concept very well, like how do we analyze the trend with the help of the moving averages, right? So guys, in this lecture video we have done first type of measurement of trend, that is called moving averages, right? Rest we will do in the next video lectures. Thank you.